This is Homeschool 101, a collaboration between ABS Television and the Ministry of Education. Stay attentive and attempt all activities. And now, today's lesson.
Bonjour à tous et à toutes. Bienvenue dans Homeschool 101, l'édition française. Je suis Madame Richard et j'ai mes élèves qui nous rejoignent dans la classe virtuelle. Dites bonjour et présentez-vous les élèves.
Je m'appelle Amaya James, j'ai 17 ans et je suis étudiante à lycée Antigua Girls High.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Natasha Saint, j'ai 6 ans.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Javante Barrett.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Justice Hughes, j'ai 14 ans.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Damon Salon, j'ai 16 ans.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Kizaya Carson, j'ai 15 ans.
Alors bonjour tous les élèves. Many of us are in love with the idea of studying French. Think back to when you first started learning it. The clichés, the culture, the sound of the language. Ah, le français. Ah, le français. Langue de l'amour. La culture de vin. La baguette, la mode, les croissants. Quel style, quelle élégance, non? Beautiful, right? But learning French in the classroom can be a lot less romantic than that. And it can even be hard, especially for you Form 5 students preparing for CXC. You'll definitely need some practical tips to help you to prepare for success at CXC. So I've put together 8 of the most practical tips. Les 8 astuces pratiques pour vous aider à préparer l'examen CXC. But first, I will outline the papers for the CSEC exam 2020. Et c'est parti. Je suis sûre que vous savez déjà les éléments de l'examen CXC. I am sure you already know the elements of the CXC exam. You have been learning French for a while, but let's quickly go over them. Let's look at paper 2. Paper 2, c'est la production écrite et la compréhension écrite. Now this is the writing and the reading paper. Vous allez à répondre à 10 situations. Vous devez écrire une lettre et vous devez compléter un dialogue. Vous avez aussi à faire une compréhension. Alors, la première épreuve pour l'examen, c'est la production écrite et la compréhension écrite. Vous allez faire 10 situations. Vous devez faire une lettre. Vous devez compléter un dialogue. Et vous allez répondre à des questions pour un petit passage en français. So, this is the paper 2. And you will be doing reading and writing. You will respond to 10 situations in French. You will write a letter. You will complete a contextual dialogue. You will respond to the questions in English for a comprehension passage, which will be in French. Now, let us move on to paper 1. For paper 1, the paper consists of listening and reading. C'est la compréhension orale et la compréhension écrite. You will be responding to multiple choice items based on short public announcements, short messages, and ads. Alors, vous allez répondre à des questions sur des annonces courtes, des petits messages et des publicités. Alors, passez par épreuve numéro 3. This is paper 3 and this is the speaking paper. Là, vous allez parler. Vous allez parler en français. Vous allez répondre à 5 situations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 situations en français. Vous allez lire à haute voix et vous allez participer à un entretien guidé. Une petite conversation. A little conversation. So, this completes the papers that you will be doing this year for CXC. Students, les élèves qui sont dans la classe virtuelle, est-ce que vous avez écouté? Vous écoutez? Alors, vous pourriez me dire quelles sont les 4 compétences que CXC va évaluer? What are the 4 skills, the 4 main skills that CXC will be looking at for this exam, students? Do you need me to give you a hint?
Parler.
Parler, oui, c'est ça. Très, très bien, Natasha. Amaya?
Écouter.
Très, très bien. C'est parfait. 2 autres compétences?
Écrire.
Écrire, c'est bon. Très bien. Et? Une autre compétence?
Lire.
Et? Pardon?
Lire.
Et lire. Très bien. Alors, les 4 compétences sont parler, écrire, écouter et lire. In order to read, write, listen and speak well for CXC, you are going to need these things. You're going to need to have une bonne vocabulaire en français, a good repertoire of simple French vocabulary. Une bonne prononciation en français. Good French pronunciation so that people will understand you. Et une bonne grammaire. Good grammar. So, the question is, how are you going to build these skills? So, let's get into the 8 tips for preparing for CXC. 8 astuces pour préparer à l'examen CXC. Let's look at tip number 1. Tip number 1, c'est lisez et écoutez beaucoup de français. Beaucoup, beaucoup de français. Read and listen to lots and lots of French. Why? Well, because what goes in naturally comes back out. If you never listen to French, if you never read it, you will never be able to speak it. C'est très important. Also, because good grammar and word order and vocabulary are learned when you see and you hear the French. The only way to really learn pronunciation is by hearing the language. And so, that is why it is important to be exposed to a lot of French. Now, what are you going to do in order to expose yourself to the French? Well, vous pouvez regarder des courts films, some little short films, des courts-métrages. You can read passages in French. You know those passages that your teacher gives you, the ones that you don't read from French for CSEC? Yes. You need to go back, pull those out, and read them over and over again. And also, this one is a little more fun than French for CSEC. You can listen and sing along with French songs. Now, je vais jouer une chanson. Et je veux que les étudiants dans la classe virtuelle identifient la chanson.
La boîte n'est pas le meilleur endroit pour trouver quelqu'un, alors je vais au bar. Mes amis et moi prenons des shots à une table et parlons doucement dans le noir. Tiens, par là, j'aimerais simplement discuter avec toi. Fais-moi confiance, je ne mens pas. Prends-moi la main, stop. Mets ma chanson au jukebox, viens danser avec moi.
et je chanterai. Tu sais que je te veux. Je sens que tu es fait pour quelqu'un comme moi. Allez maintenant, suis-moi. Je suis sûrement folle, je ne sais pas. Dis-moi si je parle trop. Allons danser, mets ton corps contre moi. Allez maintenant, suis-moi. Allez maintenant, suis-moi. Je suis amoureuse de ton corps. On s'est attiré sans effort. Même si mon cœur l'est aussi. C'est mes yeux qui t'ont choisi. Hier soir j'étais dans tes bras.
Est-ce que vous savez, est-ce que vous connaissez la chanson?
Is it Shape of You?
Oui, c'est ça. Oui, en français. Alors, voilà. So there's how you can learn French and still learn it in a fun way. Tip number two. Astuce numéro deux. This is my favorite, I must confess. Faites les virelangues. Do tongue twisters. For pronunciation. Pour la prononciation. Alors, les élèves ici dans la classe virtuelle, est-ce que vous voulez essayer la virelangue? Can you try the tongue twister for me?
En chasse.
Pardon?
Let me see.
Ça c'est vous, Javante?
I'll try it.
Yes. Allez, vas-y.
En chasse, sachant. I can't see it. En chasse, sachant, sache sans son chien. Et un bon sache.
Ouh, bravo pour toi. Bravo, bon travail. Anybody else want to try it? Give it a go.
I'll give it a go.
That's you, Amaya.
Chasseur, sachant, chasser sans son chien et un bon chasseur.
Très bien, bravo encore. Bravo encore. Anybody else want to try this one? Vous voulez essayer encore? Ok, vous. Non? Alors, nous allons essayer une deuxième virelangue. Quelqu'un veut essayer la deuxième virelangue? Natania?
Yes, ma'am.
Tu veux essayer la deuxième virelangue?
Je suis ce que je suis et si je suis ce que je suis, qu'est-ce que je suis?
Très bien, bravo pour toi. Est-ce que. Une autre élève veut essayer. Does someone else want to try?
Je suis ce que je suis et si je suis ce que je suis, qu'est-ce que je suis?
Très, très bien. Très, très bien. Bon travail. So, why do tongue twisters? Just because they're fun? Not necessarily. You can do tongue twisters to build your pronunciation. They help you to practice each specific sound. You can practice your vowels and your consonants and the sounds repeat, and that really helps you to pronounce better in French. French and English, when we speak them, they use different parts in your mouth, your nose, your throat, and different positions of the tongue. And tongue twisters help you to get accustomed to the positions in French. So it is an excellent way to prepare, especially for those pesky reading passages at CXC, and even for the listening comprehension. Très, très bien. Alors, passez par astuce numéro 3. Apprenez les mots de haute fréquence. Learn high frequency words. What are high frequency words? Well, these are words that we use frequently in everyday life. We all know that the French and English dictionary are very full of words that we often don't even use. So what you want to do is you want to learn the words that French people use often and every day. So you can learn your high frequency verbs. And here I have some really good examples of verbs that we use often. Aller, faire, avoir. Since I've been talking here, as a matter of fact, I've used the majority of these verbs. I said to you when I was talking about the exam, vous devez répondre à des situations. That is a very good example of the use of the verb, devoir. So as you're learning them, you learn their meanings, and you go on to learn the tenses and the structures. Adjectives, nouns, just as important. Adverbs, to talk about when something happens and how it is happening. These are some popular ones in French. Moving on to tip number 4. Astuce numéro 4. Apprenez à faire des phrases courtes et assez simples. Learn to make short and simple sentences. Students, your French is really at a beginner level, and so making sentences that express very simple, concrete things is really what you are trying to do at this point in your preparation for CXC. I have a really good example here of a young lady's work from a few years ago who ended up getting an A for writing. And if you notice, she made herself a little bubble, and then she planned before she wrote. She made some short little sentences. This is about her, and she says, j'ai 16 ans, simple sentence. And she went on to say when her birthday was, etc. And she made another little bubble to set herself up for making some short, simple sentences. And then the result was this. She wrote a letter, which is two CXCs, 130 to 150 words, standard, by putting together all the little sentences that she made. So this is what you're expected to do at CXC. You are not expected to write an essay with hypothetical ideas. At this point, you are learning beginner to intermediate French. Please remember that, and learn to make some simple sentences. So we see here her conclusion, and she did a very, very good job. This young lady got an A. So if she can do it, you can certainly do it. Let's look at astuce numéro 6. This is where we make the language personal. Learn the vocabulary that relates to your everyday life. Learn the what, the who, the where, the why, and the how of your life. Learn vocabulary in your centers of interest, and learn to talk about what you like and dislike. Alors, Natasha, est-ce que tu aimes la musique?
Oui.
Oui? Quel type de musique préfères-tu?
J'aime la musique de pop.
La musique pop? Très bien. C'est bon. Bravo pour toi. So, students, you've been doing French for a while. Les élèves dans la classe virtuelle. Give me some of the themes that CXC asks you for when it comes to vocabulary, students. What are some themes?
Home and family.
Yes, yes.
I would say school and career.
Yes.
Travel, oui, c'est sports.
Mm-hmm. Oui, continue, c'est correct.
Shopping.
Oui, c'est bon?
Yes.
You almost have all of them.
Did we say sports and recreation?
Yeah, I said sports.
Yes, there's, I think you have one more. One more.
School and career, sports, travel, shopping.
Yes. Hint. Daily. Things you do every day.
Daily routine.
Correct. C'est ça. Alors, so why do you suppose CXC gives you these types of themes? Natasha or Amaya, why do you think CXC gives you these types of themes?
So that you can relate to your everyday life.
So that you can, pardon?
You can relate what you're writing and what you're saying to things that you do every day.
Exactly, exactly. As I mentioned earlier, they're not going to give you things to write that are outside of your experience. So that fits right in to making it personal. CXC makes it easy for the Form 5 student to relate, or even the Form 4 student for that matter, to relate to the syllabus. All right, so you need to take advantage of that. So you, once again, You learn the vocabulary that relates to everyday life. You learn vocabulary in your centers of interest. And you learn to talk about your likes and dislikes, as we were just a few minutes ago. Alors, passons par astuce numéro 7, qui est use the language. Now, this should be very obvious, students. However, some of you are doing French and don't actually want to speak the language. Suppose I told you that I was going to learn to play basketball, but I did not want to actually touch the ball. Students, if you're learning to play the piano, you have to touch the keys. It is the same thing with French. You must use the language, because if you do not, you will lose it. So you get together with friends and classmates who are also studying French. And if you're lucky enough to know somebody who speaks French, well, then practice with that person as well. You speak only French when you're talking to your teacher. Students all over Antigua, Form 5 students, please approach your teachers in French. I beg of you. Merci. Describe things at home. Quand tu es à la maison, tu peux décrire la table, décris ta chambre, décris la cuisine. Aller dans le jardin. Okay? So, this tip, c'est super important. Because this tip actually speaks to the whole goal of you being in that class in the first place, students. All right? So, in order to get through on CXC, you cannot do it without utiliser la langue. Travailler la langue de français. Alors, nous allons continuer avec astuce numéro 8. Astuce numéro 8 is be brave. And I'm wishing you bon courage. Here are some tips for the exam, some general tips. Build your willpower. Willpower is important. If you are hungry, if you are tired, you're going to have a difficult time getting through a challenging moment, getting through that exam. So, prends ton petit déj. Prends ton petit déjeuner. Have your breakfast on the day of your exam. And that's whether it's morning or it's afternoon. Have your breakfast because, you know, they say it is the most important meal of the day. All right? Stay hydrated. Drink some water, because all of that will affect your ability to really push through. Read and listen to the questions and the instructions very carefully. Faites attention aux consignes et écoutez les consignes très attentivement. Faites attention. Many of the instructions are in English, and sometimes when students make some little errors, it is because they have actually misread the instructions. So, especially the ones that are in English, make good use of that. Read them properly. Don't make careless mistakes. And that brings me to my next astuce. Under my astuce, it is don't be afraid to make mistakes. We all make mistakes. That's a part of learning. Especially when you're learning a foreign language. I spoke about the piano keys and the basketball. Who hasn't hit the wrong note when they were learning to play music? Or thrown away the ball when they were learning a sport? That happens, and it happens with language too. Don't be afraid of it. Respond to all exam questions. Don't skip any questions on your exam. And last of all, never give up. Ne jamais abandonner. Never give up. I'd like to say a big merci to the French Teachers Association, Madame Carole Laurent, Mademoiselle Annick Adams, Education Officer Mr. Renee Young, and the rest of the FTA for helping us to make these lessons happen. I want to say a big, big, grand, grand, grand merci aux étudiants qui sont dans la classe virtuelle et à Zara Errol, who is our FTA consultant. Les élèves, I'm going to call on you for the last time, just to say your au revoir. Okay? Take leave, students. Talk to us in that last bit of French.
Au revoir, à bientôt.
Au revoir, à bientôt. Tout le monde, everybody has to do it. Everybody has to use it. Natanya, you're next.
Au revoir.
Au revoir, Duran.
Au revoir.
Au revoir, Javonte.
Au revoir.
Au revoir, merci. Merci. Au revoir à tous et à toutes. And happy learning and bon courage sur CXC.
You've been watching Homeschool 101, a partnership between ABS Television and the Ministry of Education. Thank you for viewing this lesson. Join us again next time.